Welcome. In this video, we will see how to find a term independent of x in a binomial expansion. For that, let me just take a simple example so that we can see how to work out with this type of problems. So root x by 3 minus 4 by x square whole to the power of 10. So in this expansion, there are terms where x will cancel out and you will have only constant. So my approach will be to take the generic term and equate the power of the x to 0. Because if the term is independent of x, that means it's only constant. I can put it as x to the power of 0. So in the generic term, whatever I get, that I will equate it to 0 so that I can find out the value of r. So for that, let me go ahead and find out the generic term or general term of this tr plus 1 equal to ncr. We know that ncr, that's 10cr, x to the power of n minus r, x is x to the power of half by 3 whole to the power of 10 minus r into minus 4 by x square whole to the power of r. Now I am not worried about all the coefficients there. I am more worried about what is the power of x. So I will simplify that. Minus 10 cr minus 1 whole to the power of r, because we don't know what's the value of r. Then let's see, I have 3 to the power of 10 minus r, so I'll put it as 3 to the power of 10 minus r, and here I have 4 to the power of r. This is the whole coefficient part, and after that I have x to the power of 10 minus r by 2 into this 2r, which goes to the numerator, this becomes minus 2r. Now this is the part I have to simplify, and this part I am going to equate it to x to the power of 0. That means this is nothing but equal to x to the power of 0. Now let's simplify this. What is this? If I simplify this, this is nothing but 10 minus r by 2 minus, can I say this as 4r by 2? So that I can take LCM and equate it to 0, gives me 10 minus 5r equal to 0, and that gives me r equal to 2. So I know r equal to 2. So let me just find out. Let's put C here. If r equal to 2, what this happens? What this becomes? 10 minus 2, 8. 8 by 2 is 4. That is x to the power of 4 here. Then minus 2 into r, x to the power of minus 4. See, 4 minus 4 is 0. So we are pretty much fine with the value of r we have. So let's find out what is the value of this, because that will be the term which will left out. This x to the power, this whole thing will become 1 because it's independent of x. This is the only value which is left out with me, which I have to find out. So that is 10c2 minus 1 whole square, 4 to the power of 2 divided by 3 to the power of 8. We need to do one more simplification, which we will do. This is nothing but equal to 10 into 9 into factorial 8. By factorial 8 will go. This becomes 2 minus 1 whole square is 1. 4 square is 16 by 3 power 8. So this is nothing but equal to 8 times, and 3 square, 3 power 8, so this becomes 3 power 6. That's nothing but 80 by 3 power 6. Let me check what is 3 power 6. 3 threes are 9, 9 threes are 27, 3 cube is 27, so 3 power 6 is 27 into 27. That is 729. So that will be the value of the term. By the way, what is this term? R equal to 2, what is this term? This is the third term. Remember that always, right? T of R plus 1. That is nothing but T of 3 because R is equal to 2. So the term is third term and the value is 80 by 729. That's the answer. Let me just recap this. How to do whenever you have to face this problem is, go ahead with the generic equation. Find out x to the power of, simplify what is the x to the power of, x to the power or the variable whatever is there, right, to the power of that, independent of x, so x power, simplify it in terms of r, we have done this, equate it to 0 because it's independent of x, so you can say x to the power of 0, from there you will get the value of r. Once you get the value of r, find out the quotient, because it's independent of x, the only the term value will be nothing but the quotient of the term. That's nothing but we got it here as 80 by 729. So this way you can do lot of examples to find out the term independent of x. Okay, right. Thank you. Thanks for listening. Bye for now.